Live, Councillor.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Winnipeg Committee for Safety, dated Friday, January 21st, 2022. The time is 11:38 a.m. I want to quickly acknowledge that we are on Treaty 1 territory, traditional homeland of the Métis Nation, that I have the privilege of living on. I also want to acknowledge our ancestral territory lands, as well as that our drinking water comes from Shoal Lake number 40. Today with us, I am currently the chair, City Councillor Vivian Santos, for the committee safety. And then we have with us today on online through the Zoom, we have, and I'm going to read them in alphabetical order, we have Abby Adetu, Jesse Andrushko, Kathleen Bell, Gary Black, Tony Bolt, Barclay Engel, Narendra Mathur, Sarah Pritchard, and Tracy Proctor. I also have the Safety Committee Coordinator, Ms. Crystal Van Den Busch. And from the Winnipeg Public Service, we have Greg McPherson, who's the Administrative Coordinator for Community Services. Welcome. And as well, we have from the Winnipeg Police Service, Sergeant Brian Tripolo. Our city clerks today who are working in the West Committee Room and our technical support and our minute takers with Rebecca Ford and Jennifer Ridge. Welcome, everybody. I'll go straight into the reports. It's great to see some new faces and some old faces. I want to welcome you guys to your first committee member committee meeting, and I look forward to working with everybody moving forward. I was told by Crystal that she's kind of prepped you for this meeting, and it's not going to take very long, but I do appreciate you guys taking the time out of your busy schedule and hope you guys are keeping warm and safe. So I have a couple of things that I wanted to provide an update to the committee members and some of the work that we're kind of currently doing for this year. And the previous, of course, committee members are fully aware of some of the work that we're doing. But as you know, this winter has been fairly cold. And the biggest concerns for me are the people who are living on the streets and don't have an address, right? So the big concerns that I have all the time is how are they able to stay warm? We have really fantastic partners. One of them is End Homelessness and Main Street Project, who do a lot of the work for the city of Winnipeg, and we partner with them by providing them with some funding. And so Main Street Project has a really fantastic outreach program where they have two vehicles and they go out and they visit the people who are there living in the encampments. Most of them are within the inner city of Winnipeg, and then some of them also are in my ward as well, in the Point Douglas ward. And I hope you guys take the time to figure out where the boundaries are, but it's all of it is online. You can always if you see somebody within distress, you can always call 911, but you can always call their outreach van. The number is 204-232-5217. There's also other organizations that we partner with too, like Mama Way Ichita and Safe House through Mark Carmel. They also have outreach vans as well. If Main Street is busy, they always take some of the work as well. And a big wonderful initiative that was done last year in December was the Our Relatives Place, the Dedeaway Place. That's just on Disraeli. That's a fantastic, it's got 150 beds that they were able to open up and provide some overnight shelter for people who do want it and is accessible. And it's a wraparound Indigenous-led support. So I'm very excited that they were able to open it in such quick, swift circumstances, and they were able to open it before the winter time. Another initiative that just was announced, I don't know if it's actually been made public, but I did get an email from our CAO, Mr. Mike Jack, And he had made a mention that the Winnipeg Fire Paramedics were identifying some life safety hazards within our temporary encampments, more specifically within the inner city and on City of Winnipeg properties. And they were trying to figure out ways to mitigate some of these risks, because as you know, there were incidences that happened in the past with fires that were happening, and people have actually passed away. So what they've done is they're coming up with a bit of a pilot project. They're going to be supplying with the partner agencies 15 burning barrels, which then can be used to help in house, like for warming fires within these encampments. They're saying that the, and I'm going to read from his email, the burn barrels provide a safer alternative as the fire is in an open air contained and the emissions of the embers are reduced. The partner agencies will distribute the barrels to identified encampments located on city-owned property. The locations of the barrels will be documented, and the barrels will be picked up in the spring when the warming fires are no longer needed. It is under our jurisdiction. They have mentioned that the outdoor use the burn barrels are permitted for outdoor use with a permit under the Neighborhood Livability Bylaw, with the exception of requirements for spark arrestors. They've amended the processes to allow these burn barrels in a temporary encampment without the need for a permit. If there's any questions, I don't have all the answers, but if you do have questions, please reach out to me. I think Assistant Chief Scott Wilkinson, he's been leading this project. That's kind of a long-winded opening segment. I apologize, but we haven't had one of these meetings in a while, but I wanted to provide those updates to the members. And then I think that's all I have for now.
Councillor, can you also have them move the minutes of the meeting from October, please?
Oh, thanks. You should have interrupted me.
Oh, no.
To let me do that first. I apologize. Okay, if I can have someone from the committee to move the minutes of the meeting held on October 19, 2021 to be taken as read and confirmed. All you have to do is just raise your hand. Whoever wants to be the mover and whoever I see first, and I see Narinda's hand is up first, he will move the minutes, and then I'm going to call the question. All those in favor, and if you can raise your hand, and then I can see all your hands, because I know everybody's on mute, that you're in favor. Perfect, and that is carried unanimously. Thank you. And then if I can have somebody move my verbal report as for information. Thank you, Gary. And all those in favor? Okay, good. Excellent. And that's carried unanimously. All right, we will go on to the second report, which is the Winnipeg Committee for Safety Citizen Member Appointments. Just give me a second, and I'm just going to open up the document here. So last year, we had a few outgoing members finish their three-year term, and it expired on December 31, 2021. Oh my goodness, I got to think of the years. And I want to thank them for being part of us. Some of them was, Crystal, if you can help me remember, one of them was Carrie LeBlanc. And I believe there was another member that their term expired. Sorry, the name escapes me.
That's okay. JD. Yeah.
And then was there another one, or that was it?
Bridget Whipple, yes. As well. Yeah.
Yeah. So I want to thank them for their time. And I want to welcome back Narinder. He's going to do the balance of his three-year term expiring December 31, 2022. So he's come back to return and be with us for another year. And I want to welcome the new members, Abby, and I believe Abby, I think it's my understanding you would like to have your full name represented at the committees moving forward, and please correct me if I'm brutalizing your name, but it's Abby Oden. Did I get it right, Kate? Abby Oden, a day two? Okay, perfect. We will continue on to use that as your name. And I noticed, Jen, in the beginning on the in the front of the agenda, if we can actually correct that so we can ensure that Abby Yodin's full name is represented properly on the documents.
For sure.
Thank you. We can do that in our next meetings. Barclay Engel, I believe, is here. Welcome. Jesse Andrushko, welcome to our meeting. And Sarah Pritchard, thank you. Welcome. And you guys will be here for a 3-year term expiring December 31, 2024. So that was moved at EPC, and we're here to, I believe, ratify it. Is that correct, Jen?
Yes, correct.
Okay, good. If I can have somebody move that, the new appointments. I see Kathleen's hand. Okay, all those in favor? Excellent. And that is carried unanimously. Right, on to the next agenda. Agenda number 3, 2022 Winnipeg Committee for Safety Work Plan and Budget. I'm going to turn it over to Crystal to give us an overview and update. Take it away.
All right. So before I get into the work plan and budget, I just want to give a quick disclaimer. And I know that everyone around the table right now knows about kind of where we're at with the CMNCP and the Strategic Action Plan. But in case there are members of the public who are listening in, I'll just kind of explain a little bit about why we're releasing this work plan today. While we're at the same time working on a strategic action plan that will have more robust and concrete strategic action plans, measurable outcomes, things like that. So we are in the process of working with the Canadian Municipal Network on crime prevention. That's mentioned in this work plan. And we have had a few meetings with them so far. And their work plan, their strategic action plan will be completed with us, I want to say, towards the end of May, at which time then we will release that document publicly. But the reason why we are submitting this work plan and budget today is because we are mandated by council to provide this information at the end of January of every year. So the timing of it all is a little bit awkward, but it also goes to sort of explain why the wording of this work plan, it's traditionally quite flexible. We want it to remain flexible and open, but some more concrete actions will come down the pipe sooner in the next few months. So just wanted to give a disclaimer in case there was any confusion about those pieces. So everyone has read over this work plan, and thank you for your feedback. Some people noticed some grammatical errors and alignment errors and things like that. So it's really helpful for me because I've looked at this 1,000 times, and it's always helpful to have other sets of eyes on things. So thank you for taking the time to read over. So I'll just kind of quickly go through some of the key pieces. The policy statements on each of the pages are the same every year, so those have not changed. The action items are really what's the difference. So I'll just quickly start with the first one. If you have it in front of you, then you can follow along, of course. Research and development. So here I'm speaking about the Canadian Municipal Network on Crime Prevention, or CMNCP. We're working on that multi-year strategic action plan, as I just mentioned. And this process has begun with, or will begin with, data collection. So CMNCP is doing their background work, looking at what is the landscape of community safety in Winnipeg. What are the contexts? Who are the players? What's involved? What are the strengths? Which is one of the good things I like about their approach, is that they're looking at what's good about Winnipeg. What do we like about it? Where do we all feel comfortable going, taking kids, things like that. But of course, addressing the challenges as well. So the new members have met with CMNCP and kind of given their feedback. And we will continue to have those internal meetings with them. The data collection piece. We'll be having a large group consultation. I'll talk about that actually a little bit later. But that will inform really hearing from the community, what's going on in the community, what are they seeing, what are their concerns. From there, the committee will identify two equity deserving groups and two priority populations, and then we will assist them with doing their own consultations. And the reason for that is, in CMNCP's experience, that it's better to do sort of an arm's length kind of process like that, because the community groups that are doing this work, they already have relationships, obviously, with the people that they're serving. And so it's more of a, I guess, a safer space for people to give their honest feedback, as opposed to, you know, a different entity that they're not familiar with coming in and asking for feedback. So that is all being decided and underway, which of those, who the committee identifies as those groups that we'll reach out to. The second page, I'll move to action items with support. So yes, the DIY consultation process that I just spoke about, and we'll be inviting our organizations from the community. I have a list right now. I think I have 102 organizations so far that will be invited. I expect that not everyone will be able to attend this. So I'm casting the net very wide, and we'll just see who can participate. And the purpose of that is really to, again, ask the community organizations, you know, what is working, what is not working, how can this committee be of service to the community in some very real and tangible ways, including policy recommendations. So, and again, I'll just continue to support people, organizations with in-kind support, which is just sort of the background behind the scenes work that this committee does. I'll move to education and awareness. So our toolkit is always open to, you know, it's meant to be a living document where we can add things to it. And so we'll continue to hear from people of what kind of information is needed with that. We'll continue to promote activities, safety events, workshops, things like that via social media and all of those pieces. In terms of the Winnipeg Safe City Initiative, I'll be working with them on your behalf to support some public education pieces for Sexual Assault Awareness Month in April, and then the 16 days of activism towards the end of the year. And of course, you know, once we get back to having our regular meetings, we can certainly continue to invite representatives from, you know, community organizations to come in and speak with our committee and teach us about their great work. That's one of my favorite parts of doing this work, is hearing from folks who are on the front lines. And I know that for a lot of the members, that's an important piece of this role as well. So we'll continue to do that. I'll move on to the next page, which is Bridge. Again, we will, like I said, continue to promote some safety related events and workshops and resources. I anticipate that we will still get requests for the please slow down signs. That hasn't seemed to slow down yet, even though we started that campaign back in 2018. There still seems to be a real thirst for addressing residential speeding, and I'll talk more about that in a little bit. A lot of this work is just continuing what we're already doing. So yeah, it's just keeping on with what's already been working for us. I mentioned in here, one of the things that I mentioned is to be, you know, an advisory, in an advisory capacity for counselors. And I'm working on a taxicab reporting process, just a little sort of pamphlet, clear, concise information, because there's a lot of kind of misconceptions about how to report if something needs to be reported if you're somebody who uses taxi cabs. So that's just one of the things that we're working on with the Vehicle for Hire Committee, and then we can fan that out to counselors, and they can help distribute that to the communities that they serve. And we'll continue working with the Indigenous Relations Division to support the MMIWG 2S calls for justice, and of course the TRC's calls to action as well. As well with that, we have signed on to be a signatory with the Indigenous Accord, and I believe that the ceremony for that happens in June of this year. So I will keep you all posted about that. I'll move on to advisory. I'm going to continue representing this committee on a bunch of other committees, including the Transit Advisory Committee, Vehicle for Hire Committee, the Winnipeg Safe City Initiative, and the Reconciliation Leadership Team. And you know, I'm willing to make presentations to community organizations upon request, as always. What else? Yes, this is the last year that the Community Safety and Wellbeing Program Award, those crime prevention grants, the $5,000 crime prevention grants will be running, and that will happen August, September of this year. That is a program that's coming out of the mayor's office, and because this mayor he is serving his term and will not be seeking re-election, we're not sure if that program will continue. So this is the last year for sure of that, and I'll be happy to sit on that selection committee again this fall. In terms of collaboration, we are pleased to already, we can check something off of our list of our work plan. We are adding Greg McPherson, who is the Administrative Coordinator for the Community Development Division, and he's here with us today. He is in charge of developing a crime prevention policy for the City of Winnipeg, so that's no small potatoes. He has a wealth of experience, as I've mentioned in an email introducing him, and so we're happy to have him a part of our committee now. It makes perfect sense that he's here, and so we'll you know, obviously communicate regularly and avoid duplicating our work, and hopefully strengthening each other's work. We'll continue to work with the Winnipeg Safe City Initiative, Manitoba Status of Women. All of those pieces will remain the same throughout this year. In terms of evaluation, so I hope I worded this correctly in the work plan. I think that, of course, the CMNCP Strategic Action Plan will give us more concrete, sort of measurable, you know, items that we can look to and check off of our list, which is great. We want to have more of a focus that we have had in years past. I think that with working with the community more and doing those consultations, that will keep us accountable, right? I think community is really good at keeping the city accountable, and so that will be an important piece. Continue to track the pieces from the toolkit, any related feedback, et cetera, et cetera. A lot of this work is just ongoing and kind of listing what we're already doing. In terms of accountability, of course, we will report back to EPC and council and the community with our annual report, hold those quarterly budget reviews at the meeting, and then we will release our strategic plan to the community and council upon completion, like I said, around May. Last but not least, working groups. We will, of course, continue to form issue-based working groups as needed. So I am always welcoming and interested in folks around the table who want to help out, if that's with social media or the annual report or whatever comes out of the strategic action plan. I bet we'll have to form some subcommittees. So we will do that. And of course, welcome community organizations to take part as well if they would like. Okay, so the last piece of the budget here, it's pretty straightforward stuff. Community outreach, $13,880. I want to note that we have already paid a portion of the CMNCP's overall you know, budget $4,100 has been allocated already. So you can sort of mentally subtract that from that community outreach total there. What's different about this budget than in previous years is that I've eliminated meeting costs. It doesn't look like the pandemic is going away anytime soon. In the before times, we were meeting in person and we were having lunch. And so that was part of the meeting costs. But I think for the foreseeable future, we'll just continue to meet virtually. And so the benefit of that is that there is a bit of cost savings with that. So that line has been removed. Of course, if you know a miracle happens and we can all meet in person again one day, we can. You know, there will be funding for meeting costs. We can take it from another line. As well, something that you may have noticed that is different from previous years, I have had, I allocated a bit of funding for the Winnipeg Safe City Initiative in previous years. And I'm happy to report that the initiative actually has its own funding now. So that's really great. It has not had any funding up until now. I believe it's about $16,000. So that's really awesome. They've got their own funding, and which is really great. So that line is not in this budget either. Office expenditures, my contract fee, and then there's our total. So we are working within the parameters that council has given us, and that's the end of this presentation. Any questions, comments, feedback from the committee about any of this? I'll open it to you.
I don't see any hands up. Nobody has any comments, questions? No, about the work plan? All right.
The only thing I can say is very well done.
Oh,
very
yes.
Well summarized. So thank you, Crystal.
Yes.
May I just make a request? I'd like to know about the new members, who they are, and if they can introduce themselves a little bit, that'll be great.
Sure. Yeah, we could do that. I'm just going to go to the clerk. Do we want to receive this as information first? And then if we can go to the verbal update of the committee corner, maybe that'd be a good time to have a quick introduction with everybody. Does that sound good, Jen?
Yes.
Okay. If we can have somebody move this report. Gaz, I see your, Gary, I see your hand up. Okay. All those in favor? Good, and that's approved unanimously. All right. So we'll go into item number 4, verbal update from the committee coordinator. And then if it's okay, Crystal, you can introduce the new members. And then as you introduce them, they can give a quick highlight. Thanks, Narendra, for bringing that up.
Yeah, thank you, Narendra. That's a great idea. Okay, so I will run through my coordinator update quickly. I've met with the new citizens, virtually, of course. And I'm pleased to see that they've got enthusiasm. They've got great ideas for how we can work together and improve safety for everyone in the city. So I'm really excited that they're all here. So thank you guys for being here. We've met with the CMNCP as well to do a little intro to crime prevention kind of work, and that meeting went great too. As I mentioned, I've met with Greg McPherson from Community Development Division, and I've been having weekly check-in meetings with the CMNCP just to make sure that everything's on track on our end and on their end, so that's been really helpful. I've met with the Transit Advisory Committee. We do meet once every month and a half, I think. That continues to roll along. And when items come out that are able to be released to the public, of course, I'll update this committee on those pieces too. As I said, I've made a list of organizations for the large community consults. It's at 102 now, and that is a lot, but we're casting the net wide. Like I said, I'll send that list out to the committee because I probably did miss somebody somewhere. And we want to make sure that everybody at least gets an invitation. If they can't make it to that meeting, there are other ways that they can have their input and say on how how we develop our strategic plan. So I'll send that list out to everybody. Please let me know if I've missed anybody on that list. I wanted as well to talk about, I had a good conversation with someone from Safe Speeds Winnipeg yesterday. And if you're not familiar with this group, they're a volunteer-based advocacy group. You may have seen their lawn signs around the city. They're yellow and they've got hearts and it says 30 and it's Love 30 is sort of the hashtag and the campaign line. And so they advocate, of course, for lowering the speed limit throughout the city, amongst other items. And they took a look at our work plan and noticed that there was an absence in road safety added to the work that we're doing. And I think that that's a reasonable, that's a reasonable point to make. I did speak with Clayton yesterday and explained kind of what I said already today. We've got the other strategic action plan coming down the pipe and all of those things. So that helped provide a little bit of clarity. But Safe Speeds Winnipeg is interested in working with us, and they were prepared to come to this meeting today, actually. They have action items and ways that we can work with them. So I'm going to send that document out to all of you. They are invited to that large consultation. So that will also be another opportunity for them to give feedback. But I think it's important too that we consider how road safety obviously impacts crime prevention. We talk a lot about crime prevention and we sort of look at it here around this table through a lens of social development and those social pieces. But road safety obviously is a part of community safety as well. So I will send that info out to everybody too. And if need be, we can have them come to a meeting and talk with us more about their work. The last thing I'll say, just looking at my list here, just kind of an aside, one of the more tangible items that I'm excited about, there was a meeting in December and an event that the Indigenous Relations Division held in partnership with Community Services, and it was at Sergeant Tommy Prince Place, so one of the community centers in the North End, and it was an event that was meant to bridge the Indigenous and newcomer communities, and the event went really well, and one of the things that came out of that was a real desire for women's self-defense classes, and so myself and some other people within the city are looking at hosting that and hoping to launch that on International Women's Day. So this is a direct response to the community. There's, like I said, there's a thirst for this kind of work. And so we're in the preliminary stages, but it's looking like something will happen at least, and child minding will be provided and all of those good things. So it's nice to be able to provide something sort of tangible for the community at their request. So I'll keep you all posted about that. With that, that's my update for now. I will turn it over to the new committee members, and I'm going to be mean and just call on somebody.
before you do that, Crystal, yeah. Can I just ask, have you got these neighborhood watch people also on your group of people to consult or call? And
some of them, yeah. Do you have some in mind as well?
Well, I was just thinking about them. That may be a good group to be talking about because they are spread out all over the city, right?
Yeah.
And you might get some good points coming out from them as well.
Absolutely. A lot of those groups are only on Facebook. I'm not on Facebook personally. And so if any of you are on Facebook and you have contact information that you can get and you want to give that to me, that would be helpful.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Good point. Thank you. Anything else about my update, or can I be mean and just call on some new members to introduce themselves? If hearing none, if the new members want to just say their name and maybe a little bit just about why they wanted to, what motivated them to apply to be a part of this committee and what they're kind of hoping to get out of this work. There's no wrong answers. You can just let us know where you're at. So I will call on Abby Odun first.
I saw that coming since my name starts with A. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Abiodun Adichu. I'm a brand strategist. I'm into traditional and digital media. Basically, what prompted me to joining the council is the need to see our city develop into a more safe society for everyone. And I'm hoping that we're able to achieve this with the good work you've already done and the groundwork you've already put on ground, and also bring my input to seeing how we move this forward. Thank you, and nice to meet everybody.
Thank you. Awesome. Good to have you here. Well, let's do alphabetical order. So, Barclay, welcome.
Hi, folks. Nice to meet everybody. I asked to be on the committee for personal as well as professional reasons. I work for a company called Turning Leaf, which is a mental health care company that works with folks with mental illness and experiencing intellectual challenge. So safety is our mandate in many respects. Personally, I've lived in the community for about 28 years. I'm not originally from here, but I've immediately fell in love with Winnipeg, and there's so many things about it that I'm connected to, and ultimately, I'd like to serve the community, and this seems like a really, really good opportunity to serve the community. So thanks for having me, and I look forward to working with you folks.
Thank you, Berkeley. Good to have you here. Jesse, you would be next. Welcome.
Good afternoon. My name is Jesse Andrushko. I work downtown at APTN News on their web team and social media. I joined this committee because I want to see Winnipeg become better and grow. And I think really you can't do much if people aren't safe. So good starting point.
Awesome. Thanks, Jesse. And last but not least, Sarah, welcome. Oh.
There you go. Sorry, I'm usually on Teams and not Zoom, so this is everything's just in a slightly different place. So my background is in purchasing and logistics, and I've been on several health and safety committees for some companies in Winnipeg. Like Barclay, I'm not originally from here. I moved here and sort of fell in love with the city. So part of what inspires me to want to be more involved in a volunteer way is trying to help people who were born here and grew up here see the city in a little bit more of a warm light and to kind of see what I fell in love with here. I also do some volunteer work with Artbeat Studios, which is a nonprofit that provides art supplies and studio space to people with mental health challenges and helps them express themselves. So that's something that I'm passionate about as well, as looking at safety from a mental health angle.
Awesome. Thank you, Sarah. And I like what you all mentioned about not being from here and sort of helping the folks that grew up in Manitoba see Winnipeg in a warmer light, because we like to get down on it sometimes. So it's nice to hear people move here and fall in love with the city. That's really great. So thank you all for being here and for those introductions. And we have one more new member, which is Greg. But Greg, you're on the list in about two items. So we'll just pause your introduction for now, if that's okay, and move on to the next item.
Excellent. Thank you, everybody, for introducing yourself and for that presentation, Crystal. If I can have somebody move the verbal. Narendra, thank you for information. All those in favor? Good. And that's carried unanimously. All right. Up onto the next agenda item, verbal update from the Crime Prevention Branch, which is Tony. Welcome. Yes,
there we go. Hi, thank you. Again, I use Teams as well, so just finding that a little different. In terms of the crime prevention branch, there is not a lot of updates at this time. We just got a new minister, so we are waiting for a few changes to come down, hopefully, from that and see where our priorities align. Community mobilization stays one of our top priorities within the branch. So that is in Winnipeg, is being done out of the Thunder Wing House. So that's something that's happening now. That's really all I have for you at this time. Thank you.
Sure. Awesome. Anybody have any questions for Tony? Okay, say none. All right. If I can have somebody move her presentation for as information. Gary? All right. Thank you, Gary. And all those in favor? Excellent. And that's carried unanimously. Okay. On to item number 6, providing report under the Community Services Department Administrative Coordinator, which is Greg. Welcome, Greg, to your first committee meeting.
Yeah, thanks so much. It's great to be here. Thank you very much, Crystal, for your introduction too. I really appreciate having met you and learning more about what this committee does. I've intersected with this committee through previous work over the years, and it's good to be at the table. So I'm in a new position with the City of Winnipeg for the last couple of weeks. I won't provide much in the way of an update because I only have a couple of weeks worth of work under my belt, but I've been hired basically to try to help the city create a new policy around crime prevention and public safety. So I'll be able to expand a lot more on that within the coming meetings. But basically, the idea is just to try to help move the needle on some key indicators around crime prevention and safety. And what better place to do it than with a group like this? Hopefully I can be a resource and vice versa over the coming months. So thank you very much for having me. And the last thing I'll say is I'm not originally from Winnipeg either, but I'm here since the mid-80s. And we have this thing in Winnipeg that's, we love to, we have the right to say bad things about Winnipeg amongst ourselves. But if you're ever elsewhere, like in Calgary or Toronto, and someone there says something bad about Winnipeg, Winnipeggers are extremely defensive and fierce. And I think that's something kind of cool about our city that I appreciate.
That's a good point, yes. Greg. Thank you. it's kind of like how you can insult your own family, but if somebody else insults your family, it's like, hey.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, yeah, good point. Thank you, Greg.
Awesome. Thanks again, Greg. Look forward to working with you moving forward. If I can have somebody receive his verbal report as information. Sarah, yes, excellent. I saw her hand go up. All those in favor. Excellent. That's carried unanimously. Last but not least, verbal report. Item number 7, verbal update from the Winnipeg Police Service. Sergeant Brian Trupolo, go ahead. Welcome.
Hello. Sorry, I'm actually, for clarification, it's Staff Sergeant Brian Trupolo.
Oh. Okay.
And then second of all, I'm actually sick. I'm at home taking this call virtually. Okay. So I will not be able to provide a report because I don't have anything before me. And okay. That's about as much as I can talk. I have a bit of a bad cold. Sorry.
Okay. No worries. Well, I appreciate you being here and taking the time. Definitely get better soon. And hopefully next meeting you can provide an update. All right. I guess with that, we'll just take that as for information. If somebody wants to move that for information, I'll be, I had it right, Abby Oden. Thank you. All those in favor? And that's carried unanimously. All right. Looking to you, Crystal, I don't think we have any new information.
No, that sums it up. That's about it. Yeah. Thank you, Staff Sergeant, for being here, even though you don't feel well. That's dedication right there. Thank you. No, I think that's all from me.
Okay, good. Yeah. Excellent. Thanks again, everybody, for attending your first meeting. Look forward to working with you guys further on the strategic plan. I think we got a couple of meetings kind of down the works, and we'll continue to work together and look forward to working with everybody. So with that being said, if I can have somebody adjourn the meeting, just Gary. All right. All those in favor of adjourning the meeting at 12:23 p.m. Excellent. Everybody have a good Friday. Have a good weekend. Stay warm, stay safe, stay healthy, and stay strong. That's my tagline. We can get through this together. Bye.
Bye. Thank you. Bye. Thank you.